ഹലോ മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ഹൗ ആർ യു? ഹോപ്പ് യു ആർ ഫൈൻ. പ്ലീസ് ബി അറ്റ് ഹോം, പ്ലീസ് ബി സേഫ്. ബൈ ദ വേ, വാട്ട് വാസ് ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ലെസൺ ദാറ്റ് യു ലേൺഡ്? യെസ്, ദ ഷിപ്പ് റെക്കഡ് സെയിലർ. ഹൂ റോട്ട് ദാറ്റ് ലെസൺ? ഗബ്രിയേൽ ഗാർസിയ മാർക്യൂസ്. ഇറ്റ് വാസ് എ വണ്ടർഫുൾ ലെസൺ. ദാറ്റ് വാസ് എബൌട്ട് എ ക്രൂയിസ്, എ ഷിപ്പ് ജേർണി. ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, now you have an experience with ship journey. Now we will have another experience. Shall we go out for a trip, a train journey? Do you like it? Wow, everybody loves train journey. Fine, please get ready. We are moving to the railway station. Dear children, do you hear anything? No? Listen very attentively. Something is coming. What is that? Yes, a train is coming.
Attention.
Can you hear the announcement?
Train number 16063, English Online Express, from Trivandrum to Kasaragod, is scheduled to depart from platform number 1 at 15 hours 5 minutes.
Okay children, the train has come. Be ready my kids, let's get into the train. Now we are in the train. Please be comfortable. Please take your seats. Oh, I am so lucky today. I got a window seat. I can see a lot of things through the window. Wow, it is really wonderful. Meadows, rivers, butterflies, what a beautiful sight. Okay, dear children, we are in the compartment. We are in the cabin of a railway compartment. Please be safe there. If possible, look through the windows. You can have a beautiful view. By the way, can you hear a song from a mobile phone? Yes, it's a popular song of A.R. Rahman. Have you noticed the background music of the song? It has a regular rhythm that suggests the movement of a train or locomotive. If so, shall we hear a poem with a locomotive rhythm? Dear children, please open your book, turn to page number 64. There we have our poem, The Railway Carriage, written by R.L. Stevenson.
From a Railway Carriage by Robert Louis Stevenson.
Faster than fairies, faster than witches, bridges and houses, hedges and ditches, and charging along like troops in a battle, all through the meadows, the horses and cattle. All the sights of the hill and the plain fly as thick as driving rain, and ever again in the wink of an eye painted stations whizzle by. Here is a child who clambers and scrambles all by himself and gathering brambles. Here is a tramp who stands and gazes, and here is the green for stringing the daisies. Here is a cart run away in the road, lumping along with man and load. And here is a mill, and there is a river, each a glimpse and gone forever.
Do you like the poem? Yes, it's a beautiful poem. Before we move to the poem in detail, let's meet the author.
Robert Louis Stevenson was a Scottish novelist, poet, essayist, and travel writer. He is well known for his children's classics too. His most famous works are Treasure Island, Kidnapped, and Strange Case of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde.
The poet R.L. Stevenson provides a beautiful description of the sights that can be seen from a railway carriage. Dear children, can you identify the scenes? Come on. Bridges? Yes. Houses? Hedges? Ditches? A beautiful treat to our eyes, right? This is the intention of the poet to entertain us with an exciting description of a train trip. By the way, where does the train move through? Through a village? Yes. How do you know that? Absolutely correct. Hedges, meadow, horses, etc. are part of a village. Very good. Do you have any idea of the speed of the train? Is it running very fast or very slow? Of course, it is running very fast. My dear children, which expressions suggest the amazing speed of the train? Come on, I repeat, which expressions suggest the amazing speed of the train? Yes, faster than fairies, faster than witches. Another thing, fly as thick as driving rain. Very good. Anything else? You are right. Each a glimpse and gone forever. How do you identify the locomotive rhythm in the poem? Just make a guess. Yes, by using certain words like fairies, witches, ditches. These words create the locomotive rhythm in the poem. Dear children, have you experienced the locomotive rhythm? Yes, it is the rhythm of the train. Now, listen to the poem again. It was an enchanting journey, right? But there may be some unfamiliar words which are beyond your comprehension. Nothing to worry, my children. The e-glossary will help you.
From a Railway Carriage by Robert Louis Stevenson. Faster than fairies, faster than witches, bridges and houses, hedges and ditches, and charging along like troops in a battle, all through the meadows, the horses and cattle. All of the sights of the hill and the plain fly as thick as driving rain, and ever again in the wink of an eye, painted stations whizzle by. Here is a child who clambers and scrambles all by himself and gathering brambles. Here is a tramp who stands and gazes, and there is the green for stringing the daisies. Here is a cart run away in the road, lumping along with man and lord. And here is a mill, and there is a river, each a glimpse and gone forever.
Now, we will discuss the first stanza in detail. Please go through the first stanza. What do you think is flying as thick as a driving rain? Come on, children. Yes, the sights are flying very quickly. Kavi parayunnathu, കാഴ്ചകൾ വളരെ വേഗത്തിൽ പറന്നു പോകുന്നു എന്നാണ്. യെസ്, ദ സൈറ്റ്സ് ആർ ഫ്ലൈയിങ് വെരി ക്വിക്കലി. വേർ ഡു യു സീ ദ ഹോഴ്സസ് ആൻഡ് കാറ്റിൽ? എ വെരി സിമ്പിൾ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ, റൈറ്റ്? യെസ്, യു ആർ അബ്സല്യൂട്ട്ലി റൈറ്റ്. ദ ഹോഴ്സസ് ആൻഡ് കാറ്റിൽ ആർ സീൻ ഓൺ ദ മെഡോസ്. ഹൗ ഡസ് ദ ട്രെയിൻ മൂവ്? യെസ്, ഇറ്റ് മൂവ്സ് ഫാസ്റ്റർ ദാൻ ഫെയറീസ് ആൻഡ് വിച്ചസ്. നൗ ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് ദിസ് പിക്ചർ. ഹു ആർ ദേ? വാട്ട് എ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ. ദീസ് പിക്ചേഴ്സ് ആർ വെരി ഫെമിലിയർ ടു യു, മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ. ദേ ആർ കാർട്ടൂൺ ക്യാരക്ടേഴ്സ്, വെരി പവർഫുൾ. ദേ ക്യാൻ ഫ്ലൈ, ദേ ക്യാൻ ജമ്പ് ഫ്രം എ ഹൈറ്റ്, ദേ ക്യാൻ റൺ. ബട്ട് അവർ പോയിറ്റ് സേസ് ദാറ്റ് ട്രെയിൻ ക്യാൻ റൺ ഫാസ്റ്റർ ദാൻ ദം. നൗ വാട്ട് ആർ ദ വേരിയസ് തിങ്സ് യു സീ ഇൻ ദ സെക്കൻഡ് ലൈൻ? ക്യാൻ യു ട്രൈ? വെരി സിമ്പിൾ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ. ബ്രിഡ്ജസ്, യെസ്. ഹൗസസ്, ഹെഡ്ജസ് ആൻഡ് ഡിച്ചസ്. മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, നൗ ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് ദിസ് ലൈൻ. വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദ ലൈൻ? ആൻഡ് ചാർജിങ് എ ലോങ് ലൈക്ക് ട്രൂപ്സ് ഇൻ എ ബാറ്റിൽ. ഡു യു ഫൈൻഡ് എനിത്തിങ് സ്പെഷ്യൽ ഇൻ ദിസ് ലൈൻ? ഈ വരികൾ വരിയിൽ എന്തെങ്കിലും പ്രത്യേകത കാണുന്നുണ്ടോ? യെസ്, ദ മൂവ്മെൻറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ ട്രെയിനീസ് കമ്പയേർഡ് ടു ദ സോൾജിയേഴ്സ് ഇൻ ദ ബാറ്റിൽ ഫീൽഡ് യൂസിങ് ദ വേർഡ് ലൈക്ക്. ഹിയർ ടു തിങ്സ് ആർ കമ്പയേർഡ്. വാട്ട് ആർ ദേ? ദ മൂവ്മെൻറ്റ് ഓഫ് ദ ട്രെയിൻ ഈസ് കമ്പയേർഡ് ടു ദ സോൾജിയേഴ്സ് ഇൻ ദ ബാറ്റിൽ ഫീൽഡ്. ഹൗ ദേ ആർ കമ്പയേർഡ്? ദേ ആർ കമ്പയേർഡ് യൂസിങ് ദ വേർഡ് ലൈക്ക്. ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ഇമാജിൻ ദാറ്റ് യു ആർ എൻജോയിങ് സം സൈറ്റ്സ് ഇൻ എ ബീച്ച്. വി ക്യാൻ സീ എ ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് സൈറ്റ്സ് ഇൻ ദ ബീച്ച്. വാട്ട് ആർ ദ വേരിയസ് സൈറ്റ്സ് യു ക്യാൻ സീ ഇൻ ദ ബീച്ച്? ബോട്ട്സ്, റൈറ്റ്? നെറ്റ്സ്, ഓക്കെ. ഓഫ് കോഴ്സ് വേവ്സ്. മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ജസ്റ്റ് ഇമാജിൻ ദാറ്റ് വൈൽ യു ആർ ലുക്കിംഗ് അറ്റ് ദ സീ, എ ഹ്യൂജ് വേവ് ഈസ് കമ്മിങ്. വി ക്യാൻ സേ ദാറ്റ് ഇൻ എ ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് വേ. ദ വേവ്സ് ആർ ആസ് ബിഗ് ആസ് മൗണ്ടൻസ്. Here also a comparison is taking place. This is called simile. മലയാളത്തില് നമ്മൾ ഇതിനെ ഉപമ എന്ന് പറയും. Simile is an open comparison where we compare one thing with another thing of a different kind. My dear children, please read the poem again and pick out examples of simile and write them in your notebook. There is an expression in the poem, driving rain. Driving rain എന്നൊരു എക്സ്പ്രഷൻ കവിതയിലുണ്ട്. What does it mean? Come on. Dear children, when it rains heavily, we cannot distinguish one drop of water with another one. Just like that, when we are in a fast moving train, വി കനോട്ട് ഡിസ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷ് വൺ സീൻ ഫ്രം അനദർ സീൻ. ഓക്കെ, പ്രിയ കുട്ടികളെ, ഇവിടെ എന്താണ് കാണുന്നത്? അതെ, കാഴ്ചകളെ നമുക്ക് വേർതിരിച്ചെടുക്കാനായിട്ട് കഴിയുന്നില്ല. കണ്ണ് ചിമ്മുന്ന വേഗത്തിൽ കാഴ്ചകൾ മിന്നി മറഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നു. ദാറ്റ്സ് വൈ ദ പോയറ്റ് യൂസ്ഡ് ദ എക്സ്പ്രഷൻ ഡ്രൈവിംഗ് റെയിൻ ദെയർ. ഹോപ്പ് യു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്. ഡു യു ലൈക്ക് നഴ്സറി റൈംസ്? വാട്ട് എ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ. എവരിബഡി ലവ്സ് നഴ്സറി റൈംസ്. ഷാൽ വി സിംഗ് വൺ?
Ding dong bell, pussy's in the well. Who put her in? Little Johnny Thin. Who pulled her out? Little Tommy Stout.
Did you enjoy the rhyme? What is special about this rhyme? Is it musical? How do the last words of the first and the second line end?
They end with the same L sound.
What do we call such words? Two or more words that have the same or similar ending sound are called rhyming words. In poems, usually the end rhyme is taken as rhyming words. They are written in pairs. Let's pick out the rhyming words from the rhyme Ding Dong Bell. Bell,
well.
In,
thin.
Out,
stout.
Here are the first four lines of the poem From a Railway Carriage. Faster than fairies, faster than witches, bridges and houses, hedges and ditches, and charging along like troops in a battle, all through the meadows, the houses and cattle. Find out the rhyming words used in these lines. Witches,
ditches.
Battle,
cattle.
Now let's pick out the rhyming words from the entire poem.
Dear children, when you consider rhyming words, always think about the sounds, not letters. Now you have one more work to do. Read the poem again. And pick out rhyming words and write them in your English notebook. My dear children, what is the first line of the poem?
Faster than fairies, faster than witches.
Faster than fairies, faster than witches. Is there a repetition of sounds in the line?
The sound fur is repeated 3 times in the line. Faster, fairies, faster.
Do you notice something special in the repetition?
Yes, the sound fur is repeated in the beginning of the words.
Now take a look at these lines.
The fair breeze blew, the white foam flew.
The fair breeze blew, the white foam flew. What do you notice in these lines?
I hear the repetition of the consonant sound b in the words breeze and blue. The consonant sound f is repeated in the words foam and flew.
This is an example of alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of the initial consonant sounds of words in a line. Alliteration doesn't always have to start with the same letter. It just has to start with the same sound. Can you cite an example for the same?
I can kick a ball.
Very good. The sound k is repeated in the words can and kick.
Dear children, now read the poem and pick out lines having alliteration and write them in your notebook. Dear children, can you read this line?
Fly as thick as driving rain.
Fly as thick as driving rain. Do you notice a repetition in the line?
Yes, I hear the repetition of vowel sounds.
That's good. The long vowel sound I is repeated in the words fly and driving. Now take a look at this line.
Clap your hands and stamp your feet.
Clap your hands and stamp your feet. Do you notice something similar to what we discussed?
Yes, and this time it is the repetition of the vowel sound ah.
That's a right guess. The short vowel sound ah is repeated in the words clap, hands, stamp. We call this assonance.
Assonance is the repetition of vowel sounds in nearby words in a line of prose or poem.
Pick out assonance from the poem and write them in your English notebook.
Let's revisit. The poet shares his experience of a railway journey with us. He says that the train runs even more quickly than fairies or witches. The train moves fast, leaving behind bridges, houses, fences, and ditches. It also leaves behind the green fields where horses and cattle are grazing. When the train moves forward, they look like soldiers attacking enemy in a battlefield. Poet says that the train passes very quickly through the beautiful scenery of the hill and the plain. The train passes them as quickly as one drop of rain follows another drop during a heavy rain. In a very short moment, the train crosses stations which look like paintings from the compartment window.
Now, my dear children, we are moving to some assignments. Look at the revisit section in your English textbook and answer the first 3 questions. Another work is read the poem again, draw a line in your English notebook, and write words showing movements in one side and words showing sounds in other side. I repeat. Words showing movements in one side, words showing sound in other side. Dear children, we had a wonderful train journey. We saw a lot of scenes there, like meadows, horses, houses, etc. Imagine that you are traveling in a train. Write a very short paragraph describing your travel experience in a train. My dear children, do all the homeworks. Please send it to your teachers. Okay, with that, we come to the end of this class. Take care. Be safe. We will meet again in the next class. Thank you.